You may or may not have already done calculus, and for those of you who have done it, it might seem like a really difficult subject. I struggled a lot with it in high school. Maybe you find it hard to recall what it was about. The funny thing is, though, the actual idea behind calculus is really easy and familiar. It's all about approximation. Let me demonstrate. Let's look at the classic problem in calculus, finding the slope of a graph. Say you want to know how steep a certain point is on a curve. The curve could look like anything, so why don't we start with an easier problem, the slope of a straight line. This is straightforward. In this case, the formula, actually more like the definition of slope, is rise divided by run. Let's return to our original problem and use our newfound knowledge to tackle it. Let's draw a straight line from A to a close by point and figure out how steep that line is to get an approximation of the actual slope at A. Well, that looks kind of rubbish. So let's try again with a closer point. Even worse. Okay, how about another one? And you see, this one's not too bad. Actually, the points really close to A seem to give really, really close-looking approximations. So what's the actual slope? Calculus basically says the obvious thing. The actual steepness of the curve at A is the number our approximations are getting close to. What about our other classic calculus problem, the area under a curve? We have the same issue here. This could be any graph, and we don't have formulas for those. The only area I really know off by heart is the area of a rectangle. So let's use rectangles then. Why not guess the area of the curve like this? Divide up the graph like this, and then draw a straight line from the curve to the right. Now we can just find out the area of each of these bits. Okay, so that's not an awful approximation, I guess, but there are all these hanging out bits and missing stuff. Well, we can make a better approximation. Why not divide up the curve smaller? See, the error gets smaller too. So we keep slicing smaller, and calculus tells us that the area we're limiting to is the one we want. There are lots of other problems that can be solved by calculus in a similar way. I'll talk about some more in other videos on this topic. But now, I want to bring up an issue with this whole thing. Let's go back to the area under the graph stuff. There's another, seemingly better approximation I could have done. Why not, instead of using rectangles, use these things, called trapezoids? They have a very simple area formula as well, and as you can see, the error is way less. These are better approximations, so won't they give a better, more accurate answer for the area? Well, the trapezoid way gets you close to the actual answer very quickly, but both ways will limit towards the same area in the end, as you divide the graph up smaller and smaller. Still, this is a bit worrying. If there are better and worse approximations, are there some approximations that are so bad they're wrong? I'm sorry to say that there is. We'll be seeing a really surprising example next time. See you on the other side.